What were you doing back in 1998? Well, for five Irish lads, it was the year they formed Westlife and helped boost the whole boy band music phenomenon. Now, Westlife are tied with Cliff Richard and only just behind Elvis and that boy band from the 60s, the other one, of course, the Beatles, when it comes to number one hits in Britain. Westlife's had 14 number one singles and they've sold a whopping 36 million records worldwide. But as Europe correspondent Mark Kreisel asks, after 10 years and minus Brian McFadden, are Westlife too grown up to now seriously call themselves a boy band?
I wanna know. Hunky, spunky, not all that funky. Clean, keen, and certainly not mean. That's the public image of Westlife. But the reality can be a bit different.
Jeez, I'm sorry, it's such a bad hangover, it's not even funny. I'm literally. It's in my liver, just asking me, please don't do that ever again to me.
And the winners are. Westlife!
Westlife won their 8th award as Ireland's top pop band the night before.
Hello, Ireland!
How are you all feeling today?
Great, actually. I didn't drink last night. I went to bed early.
Not really, no.
That's a lie. Yeah. Right there,
I'm
right
lying
now.
Right now, straight through my teeth. A bit of a hangover today, but we're not too bad. We're celebrating our win.
They celebrated as only Irishmen can.
Mixing champagne with Guinness.
So meet Westlife, the biggest pop band to ever come out of Ireland.
Hello, my name is Shane Phelan.
Hello, everybody, I'm Nicky Bourne.
Hi, I'm Mark Feely.
Hi, I'm Keen. It's the heart afraid
of breaking. How big? Well, they've topped the British charts 14 times. That puts them in third place for the most number ones behind the Beatles and Elvis Presley, and tied with Cliff Richard.
Yeah, but when are you going to take out Cliff?
We need to take out Cliff soon.
Yeah. We need to take him out. And we need to beat him as well in the competition. Mm. But it'd be good. We've a new single out in a week's time in the UK and Ireland.
Are you competitive in that way?
Yeah, we're quite competitive. I mean, it's not. I wouldn't know if I'd say it's competitive as such. I mean, we're just very ambitious.
Westlife still hold the record for the most consecutive number ones until this.
You had 7 singles that debuted at number one, and then Bob the Builder.
Bob the Builder. Bob the something, or
what do you think now when you hear, can we fix it?
Can we break it?
The lads were signed by Simon Cowell, who's since gone on to make millions himself by being rude to people on American Idol.
Cheap bass!
Thank you. Thank you. You can't sing, you can't dance. So what do you want me to say?
Is Simon Cowell a bastard in real life?
He's not a bastard, he's a bastard.
No, he's a rich bastard. A very rich bastard.
And while they're pop and proud, it doesn't stop Westlife behaving like rock stars and throwing the furniture out of a hotel room.
It wasn't very rock and roll because I looked out the window first to make sure there was nobody there.
He was drunk. Rock and roll. That was why he
was just, you know, it's just a silly kind of hyper giddy night out.
The incident came just before Mark admitted publicly that he was gay. Did it affect the band in any way when you came out?
We got more fans.
I wasn't very happy with it at all.
I mean, obviously every boy band does that thing with the fans, kind of fancying them or, you know, dreaming about marrying them someday. I think that people like us for our songs and our voices. It's not like I shattered loads of girls' dreams because they thought they were actually going to marry me and now I'm gay, you know what I mean? I am strong when I
am on your shoulders. And 10 years later, Westlife is still pumping out the chart toppers. Surprising when you realise that most boy bands fizzle and die after a couple of number ones, rehab and a supermodel girlfriend.
10 years on, are you still a boy band?
I think we'll always be called a boy band, you know, even if we're together and we're 50 years old, we're a pop group in our eyes, we just make pop music.
You're not going to be a man band?
We're a man band now, we're a young man band, but we feel young, I suppose, we'll take that, and we were kind of the granddads of pop there for a few years, and then take that, and boys are back now, so we feel like, obviously, kids again, because they're older than us. Spring chickens.
But all those records and the sellout tours don't mean diddly to the critics. Westlife have grown to accept that they'll never be quite cool, and they don't care.
Like, at the end of the day, the people who are buying them albums are the people who we care about. People who come to our concerts are the people who we care about, and it's our aim to continue to make the best music that we can for them, and they're our real critic.
And you might just see Kian at a beach near you. Now, he is a very keen surfer and hoping to hit the waves here when Westlife tour New Zealand in May.